Welcome back, students. We have started with the chapter on later Mughals, where we have covered Jahangir, and today we will be dealing with Shah Jahan. We'll be dealing a part of his empire, and we'll be dealing with the conquest and his life. So we all know that Shah Jahan by his beautiful Mughal architecture and establishments like Taj Mahal, Red Fort, and Jama Masjid. So we know him by his contributions in the history of India, the beautiful architectural and his architectural establishments and his beautiful like contributions towards beautiful style, like emphasis on architecture and art, patronage of art and architecture. So Shah Jahan and his conquest, we have been talking about Prince Khurram in Jahangir's era. So Prince Khurram is only Shah Jahan. So Shah Jahan succeeded Jahangir as the next Mughal emperor in 1627 CE. So he was born to a Rajput princess known as Madmati, the daughter of Rana Uday Singh of Mewar. And Shah Jahan was married to Banu Begum, who was given the title Mumtaz Mahal. We have also come across the story of Mumtaz Mahal. And he is considered to be one of the greatest Mughal. And his during his reign or during his time of rule, the Indian civilization have been one of the prosperous, have faced one of the heights of the greatest heights of prosperity. Then after, like Akbar, he was also eager to expand the Mughal Empire. So hereby we'll deal with the conquest of the Deccan and his other conquests. So conquest of the Deccan, Shah Jahan had annexed the kingdom of Ahmednagar and had written a firman to the ruler of Golconda to acknowledge his rulership or his lordship. The ruler of Golconda agreed to recognize the sovereignty of the Mughal emperor and also agreed to pay the amount as the amount of 128 lakhs as arrears of annual tribute. So that is how he extended the Mughal emperor in the Deccan in Golconda. He conquered Bijapur in 1638, Bijapur, and its Sultan Adil Shah agreed to pay him a tribute. Then for the next 20 years, Shah Jahan did not send any expedition to the Deccan, because they have already had influence over the territories of Golconda, then Ahmednagar he has already annexed, and this place of Bijapur. Then that is how he had expanded his empire in Deccan. Then we'll deal with the conquest of Central Asia. So the central, he had a desire to conquer the province of Balkh and Bukhara in Central Asia. Remember, the Central Asian countries are very rich in its spices. It's very rich in its various other important elements like cloth, silk clothing. Mainly it is known for its spices. So in order to, and it was very rich in its natural resources as well. So in order to increase trade relations with the Central Asian countries, he sent a huge army to Balkh, but the ruler of Balkh ran away, and the Mughals had to face a combined strength of the Uzbeks and other tribes. So at that point of time, now the Central Asian countries have been divided into five countries. Central Asia had been divided into five countries. But before, at that point of time, Central Asian countries were not divided, and they had various tribes. There were numerous tribes who used to rule various parts of Central Asia. So the Mughals had to face a combined strength of the Uzbeks and the among the numerous tribes. Various tribes were there were various tribes who had good warfare tactics, good skills, and who were very notorious also. They were very difficult to deal with. So the Mughal army faced a defeat, and they also faced heavy losses, which lowered the prestige of Shah Jahan. Then conquest of Kandahar. So during the reign of Jahangir, Mughal had lost Kandahar. We have come across the fact that how Mughals had lost Kandahar, and Shah Jahan made 3 attempts to recover Kandahar, but he was not successful, unfortunately. Then clash with Portuguese. So the Portuguese created, at that point of time there was foreign invasion, so Portuguese created a lot of trouble for the Mughals by looting their ships. So there was trade relations during the Mughal period. There was a trade relations with various other countries of the world. So during this particular the Mughals during the time of Shah Jahan, the Portuguese created a lot of trouble. They made Hooghly their base and used it for piracy in the Bay of Bengal. The Mughal army took action against the Portuguese and drove them out of Hooghly. So this was a success attempt by driving out the Portuguese. They had conquered the places which was captured by them, and also got back their whatever they had lost, and got back the wealth also, which enriched their treasury. So in the next class we'll be dealing with the patronage of architecture. In that class we'll be dealing with each and every establishment that was being made by Shah Jahan. That will be all. Thank you.